Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon to you. My name is Gerald Watkins II, and I'm here to display my God and Jesus Christ's gifted talent in acting. And I'm going to begin with the actor Morgan Freeman. He played a part as Joe Clark in the movie called Lean On Me. You think you could run the school? If you could, I wouldn't be here, would I? Nobody talks in my meetings. Nobody! You take out your pencils and write. I want the names of every hoodlum, drug dealer, and mistress who's done nothing but take this place apart on my desk by noon today. Reverend Slappy, you will not be the new chief consultant, Reverend Slappy. You will scour this building clean. The graffiti goes off the very next day. Is that clear? The detention students can't help you. Let them scrap this place for a while. And tan out those damn kids in the cafeterias. You treat them like animals. That's exactly how they'll behave. This is my new dean of security, Mr. William Wright. He will be my avenging angel as you teach to reclaim the halls. This is an institution of learning, ladies and gentlemen. If you can't control it, how can you teach? Discipline is not the enemy of enthusiasm. Mr. Sorella, you now be my new head football coach. Mr. Darnell, stand up, Mr. Darnell. Mr. Darnell would be your assistant. Do you want to know why you're being demoted, Mr. Darnell? Because I'm getting sick and tired of my football team getting pushed over the field. Thank you, sit down. I want a precision. I want a weight program. And if you don't like it, Mr. Darnell, you can quit. Same goes for the rest of you. You've tried and you wait for years, and your students can't even get past the minimum basic skills test. That means they can hardly read. They've given me less than 1 year, one school year, to turn this place around, to get those test scores up, so the state will not take us over to perform the task which you have failed to do, to educate our children. Forget about the way it used to be. This is not a damn democracy. We are in a state of emergency, and my word is law. There's only one boss in this place, and that's me, the HNIC. Are there any questions?
The HNIC, the head nigger in charge.
I am now going to perform the Dukes of Hazzard with James Best as Sheriff Roscoe P. Coltrane and Sorrell Brooke as Boss Hogg.
Hey, boss, that one of them tomatoes right there. No! You're going to rather do more than throw them in jail, or you can turn in your resignation and see if it has a camera.
But, boss, my little fat buddy, I'll protect you.
You dummy, Roscoe. I want Bo Duke, Luke Duke, Jesse Duke, Daisy Duke, Cuda Davenport, and I want the air parameters of a General Lee by 5 p.m. so I can have money for the J.D. Harper Lee Fund. This here's your superior officer, Roscoe P. Coltrane. Now, clean this and eat this. We got to do it for Cousin Bosch and our dog Flash. I love it.
I am now going to perform the Cowardly Lion from the movie The Wizard of Oz.
I'm the king of the forest! Not Duke, not Chinch, not Peasant, not Filth, but Crunch.
Who can stand on one leg, one paw, choppy on my back? Crunch. Who's the mightiest and the mightiest and the toughest and the toughest and the rough and the rough? Trying to sneak up on me, huh? Trying to put a fast on me, huh? I can fight with my eyes closed. I can fight with one leg, one paw, copy on my mind. I can fight those lions and tigers and bears, oh my. Come on, put them up, put them up, put them up! I've been eating in weeks, I got bags in my eyes, I haven't slept in months. Is my nose bleeding? Dorothy, don't leave. We love you. Charlie, what have they got that I ain't got? Courage, you can say that again.
Good afternoon, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gerald Watkins II. My stage name, G. Wood. All my life, where the comedy comes from, it comes from my grandmother, Drusilla Woody Goff. Here it is.
Boy, I keep trying to warn you, boy. Say one more word out of your mouth and I snap, crack, and I pop your damn ass. Keep trying to warn you, boy. You throw it on, folks. And your damn turtle food trash. Now, look, gosh, I ain't cleaning the garbage and stuff. Look, Mike, give you $5.50, supercharge your happy meal down at McDonald's. But I tell you, you don't get nothing else. Look at you, boy, you big fat shirt cup up to somebody. You look like a grimace from damn McDonald's. Look like you can eat 12 of them double cheeseburgers on it. Boy, you's a big time grimace mess. Keep trying to warn you, boy. When your mother gets off work, tell her to forget this address. I would need bumps and pumps around me. Now what you can do, you can enter through the front door, stage right. Matter of fact, I spell it slow for you, how Punky Pig said. Now get your punk ass stuck on out of this house. You don't belong in there. This ain't no place for kids. As a matter of fact, I don't know why y'all knuckleheads and airheads in the first place inside my house anyway. Matter of fact, all of you out of this house. Out of this house. All of y'all out of this house. O-W-T out. Get the hell on out of here and don't ever come back here. That's what I tell you. Get on out of here. I don't need this kind of life. And you, little Gerald Watkins Jr., I keep trying to warn you, boy. You're going to get hurt. You're going to get hurt if you keep messing with me. I'm going to put you on my knee. I'm going to put your daggone high parts, boy. I keep trying to warn you, boy. You ain't got no respect for me. You ain't got no respect for old folks either. But I tell you one thing, boy. I got to switch back in that band room that work worse than Panthers Nunchucks from Thundercats. Pow! Like a cowboy. Put some brown on your ass. That's a pretty nice thing. Put some on your ass. Boy, keep trying to tell you, boy. Now, go on about your business, and don't ever come here again until when I tell you to. Goodbye.
My name is Gerald Watkins II.